Welcome back, everyone. We continue to follow the situation. I-80 at Longview, a CHP officer who had ostensibly pulled over to help a disabled motorist has apparently been involved in some kind of a altercation there. Let's take a look now. A picture from Livecopter 3 HD.
Yeah, Walt, we are actually right over the scene here. You can see the CHP officer's motorcycle still laying there next to the guardrail. We got information that another CHP officer was actually assisting a disabled vehicle off the freeway when the motorcycle officer was falling behind him, kind of controlling traffic, when a car struck that CHP motorcycle. And that caused that motorcycle or the officer to actually be ejected from the bicycle. And you see how close it is to the guardrail. We actually hear that the officer held on to the guardrail to keep him from falling the 15 to 20 feet to the street below. So quite a scene here. Now, the officer has actually been transported to the medical facility with non-life-threatening injuries. A few other people involved in the multi-car crash has also been transported to the area. CHP is going to leave this investigation. It's probably going to be here for a little, quite some time. They do have two left lanes blocked here on eastbound I-80, causing quite a backup for people traveling along what we call the top of town. Last check, we flew over just leaving Truxell, and I-80 eastbound was definitely jammed up from at least Truxell. We'll go ahead and throw it over to Kristen because motorists are going to need to get around this.
Yeah, Dish, thanks. We'll check back in with you in just a few minutes. But in order to get around this closure, unfortunately, it's a little tough. There's nothing that runs completely parallel to where this accident scene is. This is on your eastbound side of I-80. You can see our sensors already picking up some real heavy delays. We just showed you with Livecopter 3 HD. The crash, again, just right near that Longview area. So what you might want to do, Dish said, unfortunately, the delay is already back to Truxell. Let me put this map in a little bit closer. We can see exactly what we're doing right here. This is Watt Avenue, just to give you a perspective of where the crash scene is. This is Rayleigh Boulevard, this Elkhorn Boulevard. What you might want to do if you're getting into this area and you're sticking through traffic right here, might want to just stick over onto 80 eastbound, get off on Rayleigh and take that to Elkhorn, pick up 80 a little bit further. If you need to get off and you're now around the Truxell area or through the Natomas side, get off a little bit earlier and you can take that. You can take Truxell Road, which turns into Natomas Boulevard, pick that up over on Elkhorn, and you'll be able to get back onto I-80 that way. You can see it's still a very active scene out there. Only two lanes at this point are getting by. Crews are continuing this investigation. Looks like there's some cleanup activity out on the roadways that needs to be done as well. So we'll let you know when they get things cleared up. But unfortunately, traffic advisory is still in effect, which means they expect us to be out there for quite some time. Walton, Deirdre, back to you.
All right. Thanks, Kristen. That's actually one of our photographers, Mike Domalug, who's down there and shooting the accident scene. This all started originally because a driver ran out of gas and was actually trying to push his car off of Interstate 80 over to the side. So the motorcycle officer was trying to assist by slowing down traffic. And somewhere in the middle of that, some other drivers kind of got confused or were trying to weave around the motorcycle driver. And in the end, we had a number of cars involved in this at one time. Interstate 80 in that area actually had to be shut down. And you know they never want to have to do that if they don't have to because of what happens afterward. But right now they've got about one or two lanes open as they continue their accident scene. And look at that. Can you imagine?
Yeah, the CHP.
They're actually brought that flatbed tow truck, the one that's actually turned in the corner right there, came up the off ramp, the reverse way, and we've got that CHP officer right now with a full freeway closure as they move it into position. Now, it looks like one of the cars is already hooked up to a smaller tow truck, so more than likely that flatbed's going to go ahead and load the CHP motorcycle that was involved in the crash up onto the truck and off the side of the roadway. So, just another step of continuing this investigation. Lots of CHP cars out there. Getting the investigation done with, but they're trying to make quick work of this. But then again, they have to do things by the book. They got to make sure that everything gets taken care of correctly. So they find out, they want to do everything and make sure, who's at fault and take care of the bookwork. But they're definitely there. You go. They got the two left lanes back open, but it's really causing quite the mess out there.
Right, and that motorcycle officer incredibly lucky to have not been tossed over that thing today over the railing.
The bike looks to be in reasonably good shape. CHP has issued BMWs, and they're very sturdy bikes, very good size bike. And if in a situation like this where the officer was probably hit at a decent rate of speed, the bike was able to absorb a fair amount of that. They're big BMW road bikes, cruiser bikes, and very sturdy. And as we heard earlier, the officer is apparently going to be in pretty good shape.
That's Interstate 80 at Longview Road. That's the very latest on our breaking news. We'll keep an eye on it, and we'll return you back to regular programming right now. We'll be right back.